Hi everyone, today we have with us a new unique 4G smartphone from Micromax backed U Ventures. This is an entry level 4G device aimed at consumers who want to grab a smartphone under a budget range of 5000 rupees. This device is priced at ₹4999 and is available exclusively on Snapdeal at the moment, and we have used this device for almost more than a week as our primary device, and this review is based on that particular experience of more than 1 week, right? This is the primary device even now during this review, and let's see what it has in store for you. We'll start with this back portion, right? As you can see, the back portion here, the back cover is a plastic one, but this doesn't appear cheap. The finish at the back is a bit of texture kind of thing, but it does appear plastic, so it gives you a better feel and a better hold compared to normal finish that we usually have on smartphone, the entry level smartphone. This is, as you can see, the battery, which in fact is not removable, even though you can remove the back cover. It says the battery is not removable, and this is a 2000 mAh battery, and here you can see these are the two SIM card slots. Both SIM card slots are 4G enabled. This is your micro SD slot. Apart from that, this is your 8 megapixel camera with a LED flash. As you can see, the design of the camera appears a bit like some of the Lumia devices. The design is same as in other Euphoria devices which launched recently, right? So you cannot remove the back cover battery, even though you can remove the back cover, right? Now let's start with the other peculiar feature of this device. As you can see, a single large button, which in fact is three buttons, right, at the one side of the device, right? Basically, the power button is in the middle. As you can see, a small cut here, so this is the power button in the middle, and you can press it to power on the device or the wake up the device. The bottom one and the top one are volume rockers button. Even though this particular combination may feel awkward to many of you, but after having used it for almost a week, it feels comfortable to use this particular combination. Now this is your 3.5 mm audio jack, then this is your speakers, these are the U logo. Apart from that, there is nothing on this particular side. This is your micro USB port. If you can see, here it is, the micro USB port, which can be used for charging as well as for transferring your data. This is your front camera. These are the speakers, and right, what else we have, right? So let's go straight to the operating system and see what it is. This device comes with stock Android and is powered by Android 5.1.1 Lollipop. So one of the things that I love with this device is the stock Android. Usually I do not like devices which comes with manufacturer's own UI. So this is my personal opinion, yours may vary, but I like stock Android much more than anything else. So for me this is a plus for this device. Now check out the storage. This comes with 8 GB of internal storage, and out of which around 4.5 GB is available to you. At the moment it is less available because I have installed some apps and games and taken some pictures, etc. So on a new retail device you have almost 4 to 5 GB available to you, right? As you can see in storage option, it also supports your USB storage, which means that you can add a USB OTG device on the go. We'll check it out. Here is the USB OTG device and we'll just plug it in and let's see if it mounts it or not, right? As you can see, it has mounted that particular USB OTG device, right? Let's go to storage again, and here you'll see it is a 8 GB. This is a 8 GB USB storage device and it has mounted here, right? And out of which it shows available is 2 GB free storage. You can go through that particular USB storage using the file manager, which comes pre-installed. As you can see, a USB storage option is there and you can check it out, right? So it is a pretty good addition considering this is an entry level 5000 rupees device. USB OTG is another welcome addition and another good reason to buy this device, right? We just pulled out the storage. Now let's check out everything else. Let's check out the browsing. It comes with AOSP default browser, right? And also it comes with the Chrome browser. So we'll just use the Chrome to check out the browsing. And we'll just open Android Pure and see how it goes, right? As you can see, it loads up pretty quickly without any issues. You can see the scroll is good, comparatively good, considering that this is just a 5000 rupees device. It appears quite significant without any lag. Let's open one of it. Here you can see So here it is. In terms of browsing, we do not feel any issues. In fact, the browsing was pretty smooth during all our uses, and it in fact is a good entry level device, and you won't feel that you are using a cheap device which is priced just around 5000 rupees. We also tested it for some heavy games like Asphalt 8, and you can check out our review of the gaming review in our another YouTube video. We'll just try to play a game on it. Hopefully we have a game, right? This is Riptide GP2, and during our testing of the games we do not felt any heavy or even small rating when we played the Asphalt 8 for say approximately 15 to 20 minutes. There were no issues with the heating. The device ran pretty smooth except a few what you call frame drops, but apart from that everything else was pretty good. As you can see here, this particular one is running pretty smooth, and if you consider that you have paid just 5000 rupees for this device, the gaming experience is pretty good, right? When we played Asphalt 8 on this device, we made a separate video and you can check that out also. In that particular Asphalt 8, there was a few random frame drops and a bit of lag, but as you know that Asphalt 8 is pretty graphics intensive game and it needs more processing power, but still the game ran pretty well. Here also you can see the Riptide GP2 is running quite well, right? So even in terms of gaming performance, this device performs quite great without any issues like hitting or hanging up. We played the game for approximately 15-20 minutes, even more than that, and still the device was pretty good without any lag. So we'll just come out of the gaming mode and let's check out some of the pictures that we took. The camera, let's check out the camera first. This basically comes with, this is the default camera app, and it comes with some settings like HDR mode, portrait mode, landscape mode, sports mode, flowers, backlight, candlelight, sunlight, night, beach and snow, right? Apart from that, you can adjust other settings also, like here you can see flash mode, store, picture size you can change to 8 megapixel. By default, when you use this and get this device, by default the picture size is set as 5 megapixel. You can set it to 8 megapixel, which is the highest one. Apart from that, you can adjust everything else as per your requirement, right? It also comes with some beautification mode like this, and here it comes with some filters just like the Instagram ones, right? So during our testing, we took pictures from it in different lighting conditions, and the results were good, but not so good. But considering that this device is priced just 5000 rupees, we felt that camera was pretty okay for this price range. So we'll just go to gallery and see what's what pictures that we took, right? These are some of the pictures. We'll just make the auto rotate on, right? As you can see, this is the picture quality, and it is not bad. In fact, it is good. In fact, even on zooming, you can see the details of these without any issues, right? So initially you may face some issues while focusing, but after using it for a while, it won't be a bad camera. In fact, it can take some pretty good decent pictures. As you can see, the details even on zooming are pretty good. These are some macro shots which we took from a very small distance, and that also came out pretty nice without any issues with the focus, which normally occurs with some of the cameras, right? Let's check out if we have taken some. So this is it. The camera works pretty good for a price range of 5K. Even the front camera quality is decent enough to click you some good selfies. Now apart from that, the call quality of this device was pretty good. We do not face any issues regarding the call quality, except that when the network is pretty low, which is at the moment is the case with most of the cellular networks in and around NCR Delhi, where we are at the moment, right? And in terms of lag or the performance, if you are playing some heavy games like Asphalt 8 and simultaneously trying to open some other apps, you may feel a bit of lag, but that is normal considering that this is just your 5000 rupees device with a Snapdragon 4110 and 1GB RAM. It is pretty normal if it shows you a bit of lag if you are playing so many heavy games at the same moment, right? As you can see here, the animation of scrolling is almost smooth without any issues, right? So we have opened so many apps at the moment and still it is going pretty smooth, right? It also supports FM radio, and you can play FM radio on the go. The device comes with a earphone also, which is rare for entry level devices. So overall, this device appears pretty good buy for a price of 5000 rupees. If you are looking for a 4G LTE device at the entry level, perhaps this one is the best bet I have found till now. Means I meant to check out the other options available, but unless I get my hands on it on them, I cannot be sure if those are better options compared to this one. For the moment, this appears to me a better option. In fact, the best option at 5000 rupees level. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video review. See you soon with another video review. And do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.